we're starting this morning. I'm introducing myself because we have decided as a panel that that's what we're going to do. I'm Allison Kupietzky from the Israel Museum of Jerusalem, and I'm here to talk about Wiki, women, and museums. And of course, GLAM. The Israel Museum is one of the GLAM institutions, the first one in Israel. It's like the National Library, the National Museum of Israel, and I guess it cares. And we have about 500,000 objects in our collection, and in addition to the art collection, we have archives and libraries. Now, in the archive world, we have an information center, which is something parallel to an archive in terms of how we catalog the information. And the information centers are divided into three, and the one that I'm going to speak about was with us, a partner with GLAM in providing information to the public. And we focused on artist files. An artist file is a file that has in it articles, invitations to an exhibition, artwork, anything that's connected to the artist. And we were very glad to use Wikipedia as a platform to share this information. So there are 12,000 artist files in the Information Center for Israeli Art at the Israel Museum. It was established in 1975, and there are physical folders for every artist. Online, you have access to 5,800 Israeli artists on our website, and you can click on the name of one of the artists and see a biographical page on the artist, some milestones, and then click within that page and access artwork or invitations to exhibitions for that artist. Altogether, besides the artist files per se, there's also digital articles, which are outside of the files. They're digital, they're cyber. And we also have a digitized video collection with thanks to Harvard. And we have 17,000 exhibition invitations. That's all residing within a larger museum. And the museum has 24 departments. Only one of them is considered Israeli art netto, but really the Israeli art is within other departments, for example, photography, design, and other such departments. But the Israeli art permanent galleries was our focal point for this project, where we focused on 50 artists, and they have a face in the permanent galleries. Online, if you search for Israeli art on our website, you can see some examples of some of the Israeli art. We're going to focus on Sigalit Landau, who's a woman Israeli artist, and as the title of this talk mentions, really the focal point for my talk today is how women were involved in this project. And I had in the back of my head, I heard last year at the Wikimania in Haifa, I heard the plenary speech about how there are women missing in the gender gap, and I felt that a museum is the perfect place to really focus on that need. So when we started our project, we turned to Google to search for standards. And lo and behold, there is a standard for artist files. Oops, going too fast. Our list has a group called Artist Files Revealed, where they did a survey, and we were very excited to join the group. I even visited some of the partners in the group here in Washington yesterday. So, what was our project? How did we define it? Of the 5,800 Israeli artists that are online, we looked on the category for Israeli artists in the English Wikipedia. There are about 100 Israeli artists. Today, at the end of the project, there are 157 in English. So, we saw this as an opportunity for a symbiotic relationship with Wikipedia, where we would share our information from our database. We build an artist page, an artist biographical page for each artist individually. And that would serve as a basis for a conversation with the public where they could update information. So you have to understand another point that I didn't really say early on, but in terms of staff, we're very limited. We have an impossible task to stay on top of if you consider that every artist might have an exhibition or an artwork each year. So we're talking about cataloging a huge amount of information, and staying on top and staying relevant is really challenging. So what we saw here was an opportunity to share what we knew, but let the public update those pages, the web pages, in Wikipedia, and the public included the artists themselves. So it was a wonderful opportunity for us to have a connection with the artists. So the collaborative space that we worked in Wikipedia, we worked bilingually. The museum works in English and Hebrew, so we built all of our articles in English and Hebrew. And so in order to facilitate this mutual relationship with Wikipedia, we worked with the Israel chapter. And we had a few events within our information center. And this is what Sigali Glandau's page looks like in English. And if you had a look at it before, you can see the before and after. So this is how it looked in July 2011 when we started the project. And this is how, on the right, how it looks today, a year later, where the artist sent us a better picture. Anyone on the left looked pretty awful. And she wasn't happy with it, so we updated it. We also had this skeleton of information, so milestones, you know, a bit of artwork. But after you put it online, specifically with the English, you have to remember our mother tongue is Hebrew in the museum, so a lot of the work that was done in English needed editing or fine-tuning, putting it mildly. So once we put it online in English, it gave the English-speaking public an opportunity to help us to edit these texts, and that was amazing. And in addition, the artists themselves were providing more information. So if you could take a look at what her page looks like now, I mean, it's just amazing. It's a huge difference, and we had that for 50 artists. So what was the timeline of the project? So we started in July with one of the first artists, which was Larry Abramson. I know it's a man, I'm sorry, don't shoot me. But Larry Abramson is wonderful. He's very accessible, and he was very open to the idea of sharing online with Wikipedia. And that summer, we started, which was a year ago, and I announced the project with the Wikimania in Haifa that summer. And I had wonderful feedback from the crowd, and some people are sitting here who offered to help us translate the page. So while we worked in English and Hebrew, we ended up with a multilingual I wanted to show you what the screen looks like. Can't. Sorry. Okay, I'll show it to you soon. I think I have it later on. But we ended up with, if I click on this, does it show you? Maybe some of them, not really. So we ended up with the 7 languages. We had interns from Hong Kong with us for the summer, and this summer as well, translating some of the pages. We had a Russian intern. You have to understand also, being in the Middle East, we're in the middle, which is nice. So we had interns in the summer from all over the world. We had from this summer, we had from Holland, from Germany, from Hong Kong, and this was a wonderful opportunity for us to work with these interns who helped us translate these pages. So at the end of what we call the project, where we worked with our Wikipedian-in-residence for 2 months, December, we had finished the 50 Israeli artists, and I left it to you to finish the 5,800 minus the 50, which are online. So some of the results from this project, was very early on seen, which was the great accessibility that was afforded to us through Wikipedia. We linked every page to our database, and so as soon as you come into Wikipedia and you see the reference point, you can come to us. And what we found was in the month of October in 2011, there were 600 people who came via Wikipedia as opposed to 72 through Google to our site. So the immediate benefits are clear. Multilingualism, virtual traffic, and increased awareness of Israeli art within the Wikipedia world as well as the whole outside of the world. One of the nice stories which came out of the Wikimania 2011 was I met Isaac Kaskai, who said that he would translate one of our pages to Swahili. I don't know if he's here, I haven't seen him. But we had a very nice story with Larry Abramson. So as I explained, so Larry Abramson ended up with 7 languages. We have Russian, Chinese, German. I think he's here. So he did the German. very successful. And so I sent an email to the artist, and I said to him, you know, by the way, you should know you have now on Wikipedia page in Swahili. So he wrote back, it was only time to my big international break. Swahili, I'll have to wear shades and walk in the streets of Nairobi. So, and that same day, I went to the statistics page, and I saw that there were 78 visits to that page, and I think he sent to everybody in his family that email to let them know. So besides the benefits, what I wanted to focus on were the challenges. Perfect, okay. So I'd like to focus a few minutes on what the challenges are, because, you know, getting it all done and looking at it from far is really nice, and we're very successful and we're so proud. But I want you to understand what we worked with and how we managed to move forward. So as I said, we have a very, very small staff of paid staff members, but we have a huge volunteer staff of transient people who are coming in for the summer, for the month, doing an internship. We have about 15 older women volunteers who come to us once a week on a regular basis. And so training all these people and working with all of them was quite challenging. And everybody had a job in the workflow, and I wanted to present it to you. So for example, one of our big challenges was keeping up to date with the information. So we have information on Wikipedia, it's constantly being changed. So I've created a watch list with all the artists that I'm following, and I get emails updating me if something changes. And then I filter that updated information and then I put it into the database if I see it's necessary. Now, I don't put it back into the database. I have these two wonderful ladies, Sarah and Jackie, who are retired librarians, come to my office once a week, and they put it into Wikipedia. So that was one step in our work process. I'll go into more tools in a minute. But I, of course, although we're focusing on women, I did want to give a few minutes to Yair Talmar, who's our Wikipedian-in-residence, and to speak about our wonderful experience, which was partially funded by the Wikipedia Foundation. So thank you very much. So Yair Talmar, I stalked on Facebook. It was kind of scary. I looked in Hebrew at the Israeli artist pages which existed, and I looked at who the contributors were, and over again I saw his name. So his name was quite clear. It was Yair Talmar. I mean, he signed his name. It wasn't like something mysterious. So I went to Facebook and I typed the name in, and there he was. So I wrote him an email and I said, you know, I have an idea for a project. Would you want to come in? And he said yes. And then we worked with Shigeyev's team, who's in this room. And she did the bridging, and we ended up with a wonderful project. So one of the results of this project was, during the 2 months that he was with us, he went through some of the archives that no one had really gone through before. And it is how it looked on my floor as he was going through it. And what was fun was that he found things which were useful to Wikipedia. So for example, this is the Wikipedia page in Hebrew for Shmuel Levy, who was a very early Israeli artist. And this image that you see here, he found within that box, it was part of an invitation, a 1927 invitation to an exhibition. It's now our earliest invitation for Israeli art. So it was ended up to have a lot of use of this information that he was able to find. He trained us, meaning you can see here some staff members, you can see the volunteers. Another source of human staff is our, national service. In Israel, besides going to the army, another opportunity is you can spend time in an institution to help the community. So you do this for a year or two, depending on what you sign up for. So they're right out of high school, the kids. They're usually very energetic and know a lot technologically, but don't have patience. So we worked with a few who worked with us, and that was wonderful, wonderful, wonderful experience. So you'll be seeing pictures of some young people, and that's what they are. One of the nice stories also with Yair was, in order for us to put things online, most of these artists, since Israel's quite young and Israeli art is quite young, they haven't died yet, which is a shame because makes copyrights really complicated. So obviously they did there, for sure not did 80 years. So Yair went to people's homes and got them to sign. Here we see Gideon Gaston's studio. in Shenzhen, which is near Tel Aviv, and he went there and he asked them to sign the copyrights to open them up for Wikipedia. So that was quite a challenge. Okay, so now let's talk a bit about the actual tools we used when working with our staff of different ages and challenges. I don't know. Challenges I'm using a lot. So what you're looking at here is on the left, is Avi Tanenson, who's the curator of Israeli art in the department. And he's taking us a behind-the-scenes tour of the storage room, and we're looking at the pictures. Now what you're seeing on the right here are our summer interns. So, and one national service. So Liron is doing national service, but Amy's from Alabama, and Mary is from Hong Kong, and this is Rebecca, who is, she's in Yale, but I don't remember where she's from. So they're in Israel for the summer, and they're helping us move the project forward. Although the project, as defined, was 2 months with the Wikipedian-in-residence, we are on a low burner, still continuing the project. Another person involved in this project was we were pushed especially to investigate the idea of putting videos online. And so the first step was digitizing them, and Harvard was amazing, and they said they'd help us digitize our 500 videos that were VHS. And so we just completed that project, and we're looking forward to sharing some of them on Wikipedia. So the people who worked on the project were Danielle, who's on the left, she's National Service, and on the right, is Bruce Stern, who worked on this project for the last 30 years. Watching all those 700, there were 700 videos, only 500 were VHS, and writing an abstract for each one. So this was an interesting partnership. Susan Lazinger, who's an editor, retired. She was the head of information, informatics department, maybe, in a university, so she recently retired, and she's really excited to work on Wikipedia, and all these people who wanted to help had a really, really hard time with the technical stuff in Wikipedia. So I wanted to talk a little bit about how we solved some of those issues. And if you give me a minute, we'll just listen to Barbara, who is one of our interns, and not interns, one of our volunteers, who focused on uploading all the images from our collection. We uploaded almost 500 images to the Commons. So let's go see if this works.
I think that's a real museum. And I was very, very pleased to be asked to join Wikipedia because I've been told that the information is not always accurate, and I want to help make it accurate.
Okay, so Barbara is 83. I asked her permission to give her name. She studied library sciences before there were computers, and but she really has a knack for the computer things, and it's been a pleasure working with her. She really did all the uploading of the images. Okay, so what are some of the solutions? So we worked a lot with Word. What does that mean? I mean, some of it we learned the hard way when I had these cute little girls from Hong Kong crying when everything got erased. Eric could tell the story. They worked on Wikipedia straight, and I don't think I have enough time, but I'll just, one second, it's a really funny story. I wrote to Derek, help all of our 14 artists that we translated was erased, and it took him about a month to find a solution. By that time, they had gone home, and the solution was a dot, okay? This is the story. In Chinese, when you write a name, and the first name and the last name, the separation between them is a dot. But we use the wrong dot. Now, there are a lot of dots. Did you know that? So it was automatically deleted. So at the end, Eric sent me an email with 2 arrows, use this dot, and we've been using that email and copy-pasting that dot and all the Wikipedia pages. Now, I don't know who's in charge of Unicode in this room, but I would love someone to unify the dots in Chinese. That's my personal request. Okay, so we worked in Word, because after everything was erased, and more than once, and very sad, so we typed everything up in Word, and I built a template, which I translated English and Hebrew. I could do the Chinese, but luckily, when you type a template in English and in Chinese, Wikipedia platform, it automatically translates the names of the fields, which was helpful. So we used that for Chinese, for Hebrew, for English, we used Word. In addition, when I showed you Susan Leisinger, so she translated a huge seminal work on visual art in Israel. It took her about 6 months to translate it. It's online and all invited. She only worked in Word. She had a really hard time working with Wikipedia, so she emailed me the documents, and then I put them on at the end of every session. Another tool that we use is templates. And Brian White, who is known as BG White, was very helpful behind the scenes. And he helped build some templates for us so that we could link to our website easily with just the code. And I have to thank him for that. So those were some of the tools that helped us. So I'm going to just finish by sharing with you a few pictures from our edit-a-thon that was in the museum with the local Wikipedians. And we also had a behind-the-scenes tour. And we also managed a Facebook page for the project and spoke at a few conferences locally in Israel. So thank you very much for your time. And I'd like to thank my knights in shining armor, since we did focus on women. There are quite a number of men who were very helpful. Mir Haroni, Menachem Arbel, Tomer Ashur, Derek Chan, Zico Van Dyke, Yoel Epstein, Isaac Haskell, Dror Avi Lin, Yigal Sheffer, Yair Tomer, Brian White, Evelyn White. So that is the Wikipedia volunteer team. And then in the museum, James Snyder, Dorlin, Amit Hemans, and Yigal Tsilmon are very supportive of this project. Thank you very much.